break the chain, no pain. Don't be afraid, but go on a night, same old days, same old ways. What's going on, guys? It's Metzor Jagan here, and welcome back to yet another MFM. Now, I know that I've been away for quite a while now. The latest videos that I uploaded have been about Don't Even Think, those videos regarding my Twitch highlights. So, I personally haven't necessarily been here, though I have uploaded. Now, with me not necessarily being here, that's going to be the topic at hand when it comes to this video. As you see, I am showing gameplay and other things in the background. I didn't feel like using my camera this go. I just wanted to record my voice and talk about what exactly has been going on. So I have five things listed here. The first thing that we're going to talk about is my absence on YT, which is YouTube, for Twitch. The reason as to why I haven't been active on YouTube nearly as much as I used to be is because I started to pick up streaming heavily. Quite a bit ago, I really wanted to focus on Twitch and really grow upon my streaming career. By doing so, I started enjoying the idea of just being able to boot up the stream and play and interact with viewers rather than booting up my Elgato, recording for about 20-30 minutes, or recording for however long, cutting it, having to do a bunch of stuff, and then uploading it as a video. It's just that streaming was a lot more appealing to me. Now, with streaming being a lot more appealing to me, I started losing the drive to actually make YouTube videos. Last time I had a big drive to make YouTube videos was when I was doing my Dead or Alive videos along with my World War Z videos. I would play matches, take those matches if they were high kill games and upload them along with, play ranked matches and upload my ranked matches. As things stand now, there's no real game that I care to upload on YouTube, nor really just care to upload games in general on YouTube if it requires me to record it traditionally rather than it being a Twitch highlight as I've been doing with Don't Even Think. Moving on from that, let's move on to me talking about wanting to vlog, because that's something that I enjoy doing. In the past, I did enjoy just sitting in front of the camera and talking. However, in recent times, again due to Twitch, I just have not had the drive to really talk about any of the topics that I have jotted down on my phone in regards of them being a vlog. You know, I'm not gonna lie, I did want to do it in the past, but I still have everything down in my phone that I wanted to talk about. It's just that I have no real passion to do it anymore. With that playing a major issue and factor as to why I haven't uploaded any vlogs, topic vlogs in particular, I didn't want to force myself to record these things and my passion not 100% be there and the video and the quality overall comes out half-assed. So if I'm going to record a video, if I'm going to talk about a vlog, if I'm going to talk about a topic, then I want to be there 100%. I don't want to record it just because I said I was going to do it and just to get it out there in a sense. You know, I want to be behind the idea. I want to really be about it and then upload what I was about. Rather than, oh, I said I was going to do it, let me just go ahead and get it out of the way just to put it out there. That's not the type of content that I want to do. This next subject we already brushed up on, but I listed it as not having a real passion for YouTube anymore. When I was younger, I had a really, really strong drive for doing YouTube because that was the only thing that I could do. I wasn't live streaming, I wasn't doing anything like that. And YouTube was my outlet, you know. I was inspired by Niga Higa. I tried to start out being a comedian. That didn't really work out. Then I touched into gaming on YouTube, and that's where all of my focus and drive went. A lot of people ended up liking my guides, but then I started noticing that with my guides, a lot of people enjoyed me doing the guides. However, they weren't there for me as a content creator for the long run. So I can't be mad at them, because if they enjoy a certain game, then that's what they're going to come for. If I am a variety gamer, then they're not going to necessarily support the other games that I play, rather than them just trying to get information out of the game that they are currently enjoying. So I can't really be mad at them for that, but that's not
something that I wanted to continue doing, hence as to why I stopped doing guides. Now, I say that I stopped doing guides, and you guys may be wondering, well, you did guides on World War Z. What happened with that? Did you go back on your word? Technically speaking, I did. But the actual real reason as to why I made guides on World War Z was actually to educate players in that game to get them better, to give myself a personal challenge. I wasn't doing it just to get guides out there for my channel to get recognition as guides. I literally did it because I would wipe lobbies so frequently and I would get so much hate mail to the point to where I just wanted to share my knowledge with the world, get these players to watch these videos, that way they could get better, that way they could give me a better challenge in the game. So it was pretty selfish of me to do that, but I wanted to help people. I wanted to help people to give me a better challenge so that I can have more fun with the game. So that's kind of like a double-edged sword. It's like, wow, you're an asshole. You were beating people so bad, you made guides to give yourself a personal challenge. But I'm like, look, listen. On the flip side, I'm giving people this knowledge to get better. Yeah, it's helping, huh? So moving from guides, I then stuck to just trying to do gameplays. I started dabbling in vlogging, and eventually that brought me to streaming, and streaming a lot more frequently, to the point to where I just love the idea of streaming and I lost my passion for YouTube. So my YouTube channel has kind of just been sitting here. So this is going to transition into the next topic of needing to reevaluate exactly what I do. So what is it that I do right now is that I don't pay attention to YouTube, and I stream basically every day after work, and I had a passion for voice acting that is the main career path that I wanted to do. However, I even lost a passion for voice acting. Literally, streaming took over my life. I know that a lot of people compliment me on my voice. I know that I can do anime voices, deep voices. I can voice act. It's just that streaming took up so much time of my life that I overvalued it over YouTube and especially voice acting. Day by day, I constantly told myself that I'm literally not going to get anywhere with voice acting, but I know I need to focus it more. I can say that I would like to voice act as much as I like, but actions speak louder than words. If I'm not putting out the work that is needed to get more into the industry and get more out there, how am I going to become a voice actor? I'm not. It's just not going to happen. That's something that I accepted, and that is the reason why I, again, was streaming so much. It was because I accepted that fact. It's just that I couldn't balance out the times that I would put into YouTube, the times that I would put into Twitch, and the times that I would put into voice acting. Due to recent events, I actually stopped streaming, and I stopped doing everything, pretty much. I wasn't mentally stable. I ended up getting burnt out without knowing it, and a friend of mine was trying to tell me for months, like, look, you need to cut back on streaming, you need to take some time to take care of yourself, you need to stop. And anytime I'm not streaming, I just felt like I was wasting time. So I would just dedicate myself to streaming literally every day. My body was getting exhausted. I would have bad sleep patterns, and just overlooking it, I was just burnt out, and I didn't accept it until I broke, pretty much. And also like some other personal things that was going on, but. Basically, I was just burnt out, and so I just had to stop. I had to stop making content. I had to stop streaming. I just had to stop everything so that I can take a step back, breathe, and really evaluate what it is I want to do and how I'm going to divide the time in order to do said things while working a 9-to-5, unfortunately, to keep a roof above my head. The goal in the long run is to be able to quit my job, not have to work a 9-to-5, and be a full-time content creator, be it for YouTube, be it for Twitch, and also on a as a main career, be a voice actor. And then whilst, you know, doing Twitch and YouTube as a hobby, you know, raising money to do charities and things like that. I would just really enjoy being able to be a voice actor who is also a content creator, to be able to financially live off of that, and also help out in any communities that I can, because right now I don't feel like I'm doing anything necessarily for the world. So I would love to be able to get to a point to where I can further educate myself on issues that are going on in today's time, and I can do something about it to help out. With that goal being in mind, I need to figure out a way to go about it in a more structured way. So I am taking this time to step back from streaming, to step back from the voice acting that I wasn't doing in the first place, and to reflect on my YouTube channel to see what exactly I can do different with it. Now, the dates that we're looking at for me to return would come down to March 12th and between March 23rd. The reason why I chose these specific dates would be because Nioh 2 comes out March 12th and then Bleeding Edge comes out March 23rd. These two games I felt as though I would stream and I would cover a lot. I don't foresee myself playing many other games. Resident Evil 3 does interest me. Granblue Fantasy Versus does interest me. But when it comes to main games that I'd be playing on stream, then I figured that I'd be playing Nioh 2. Of course, Dead or Alive and Bleeding Edge. Now, when it comes to Don't Even Think, I feel as though I'm very much so over Don't Even Think. I already dropped it one time and I'm pretty much so dropped it for the second time. Season 2 will be coming out this month, hopefully, but if the game doesn't get better optimized, I don't really have a passion for playing that game. I enjoy games to where there is action. I don't enjoy having to look for people, and the game overall is just like really boring, or a lot of bullcrap goes on and Don't Even Think. The only reason why I continue playing that game is because a handful of people give me a lot of credit in that game and foresee me to be the top player of that game, you know, like the top community player. I'm not trying to boast or anything, but that's how they see me, so I appreciate it, and I'm there for them, really. I'm not there for the devs, I'm not there to support the game, I'm really just there for them. So now that I have the games that I would like to play established being Bleeding Edge and Nioh 2, I need to figure out a more stable way to stream on certain days or stream at certain times and certain days, along with putting in more time towards my voice acting, along with trying to figure out exactly what I want to do on YouTube, because again, I don't care to upload gameplay, and I'm just not there when it comes to the vlog, so my YouTube channel is kind of just sitting here. The approach that I took with my YouTube channel would be the Twitch highlights. I heavily encourage anybody who enjoys me on YouTube to please go over to twitch.tv/METSURJKEN. That's twitch.tv/METSURJKEN, and follow me there, because I am a lot more active on Twitch rather than YouTube. I would like to use my YouTube channel as a Twitch highlight source. That way, people on my YouTube channel can get a glimpse of what's going on over at Twitch, and then they can come over to the Twitch scene and be a part of the Twitch community that I am trying to build. Then once things starts popping off, then I could possibly throw in, you know, life videos here and there with me going with friends, or just talking to you guys in general, along with giving you updates as I am right now. This is everything that has been going on in my life currently, ever since my last video that I posted, and my last video that I was speaking in it, not a Twitch highlight. So for those of you who are here on my YouTube channel, I appreciate you still being around, and if you could just let me know your thoughts. You know, I ask for comments, typically in the comment section. I pin my comment at the top, but I'm being genuine. I would like to know what you guys think of this channel, or if you guys have any ideas when it comes to approaching certain things or anything of that nature. I really, really, really just want to hear back from any of you who are genuinely here still watching this channel. So if you guys could do that for me, then it would mean a lot, because I would love to read it and I would love to reply and I would love to engage with any of you and all of you in the comment section. This was Matsuwa Jaken. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to leave a like. And again, please comment in the comment section below. And I will see you all in the next video. I'm out. Peace.